Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Bola. If you're new here, you're welcome. Please subscribe to the channel and turn on your notification bell if you've not. Today I'm making a sea moss and turmeric soap. I have my melt and pour here. I got it from Amazon and I'll put the link in the description box below. I have my sea moss gel. If you haven't watched the video of how I made my sea moss gel, please check that out. I'll also link it in the description box below. I have my turmeric powder that I made into a paste by just adding a little bit of distilled water. And I thought to add water so that it will be easier to work with and I'll be able to mix it in my soap. I would be using a little bit of shea butter. I got it from Amazon. I would show you how much I use as we go. And I have my fragrance oil here that I'll be using. I'm using the rose fragrance and I have my lavender flower here just for decoration that I'll be putting in my soap. Also, I will be putting a little bit of coconut oil. I got this one from Costco. It's the organic virgin oil. I got the jumbo one just so that it lasts me for a while. I use a lot of coconut oil. And without further ado, let's get right into this. So I'm going to dice my melt and pour into cubes. If you look at the back, you will see that it has that line. So that's what I'll be working with. So, oops, I'm just going to take that out of the container and break it into cubes so that we'll be able to, so that it can melt faster. And I'm just going to follow the line. So after cutting it into cubes, this is what you have. And I'm using this much shea butter. I'm not measuring it or anything. So I will put it in my bowl and I'm going to melt this with a double boiler method. And I'm going to melt that on the pot that has hot water in it. Like so. I will show you guys what it looks like in a minute when it's melted. So as you can see, it's melting, and now that everything is almost done melting, I would include my coconut oil, and I'm just using 1 tablespoon, and I'm melting my coconut oil in the pot because it's solid. If it was in the liquid state, I won't have to. I'll just put it in the mix. So that's how much I'm using, and I'm just going to wait for everything to melt completely. And I'm using the double boiler method because of the shea butter that I added. I don't want it to burn. I'm trying to keep the integrity of the shea butter. You can do this in the microwave if you're using just the melt and pour. If you don't want to, you don't have to use shea butter. You can melt it for like 10 seconds, watch, mix, and then put it back if it's not completely done until you have everything melted. But I'm doing this method because, like I said, I'm trying to keep the shea butter from burning. It doesn't take long for it to melt if your water is already hot and you can see the steam coming off of it. So that's what it is. So now that everything is completely melted, I'm going to add the sea moss gel, and I'm using that much. I'm not measuring, I'm not a soap maker, I'm just eyeballing this This is a DIY project and this soap is mine. I'm not selling it. I'm not doing anything. I'm just going to be using it for myself and maybe gift some to friends. So bear with me. So I'm going to mix, and you have to mix well. Make sure that the sea moss is incorporated fully into the soap mix. That's what I'm doing. And you have to work fast before the soap begins to form and solidify. I think that's the thing. That's the problem of using a melt and pour. So make sure that you don't have lumps in the soap mix. And that's what I'm trying to do. Break all the lumps. So now I think everything is properly mixed. I don't see any lump or lumps of the sea moss gel. I would include my fragrance, which is rose fragrance, like I said. And you can put however much you want, about 10 to 15 drops is up to you. I just don't want the smell of shea butter, and that's what I'm trying to kill off. And I would smell it and see if it has that rose fragrance. Yeah, I think that's okay for me, because I will still use the lavender flower later. And this is where I'm going to divide this into two. So I'll break this mix into two. I have my measuring cups here. Not that I'm measuring anything. Like I said, I'm eyeballing it. So I'll pour some here. And in the rest of this bowl, I'm going to include my paste, my turmeric paste. And you will see why I'm doing it this way in a few minutes. So this turmeric paste will serve as my color, right? Like, look at how beautiful that is, like bright yellow color. And that's what I was going for. So there. And then once I mix properly, I'll pour that into my other measuring cup, and then we can pour into our mold. There we have it. I have my yellow color and my white color. So this is one of my mold, and I've washed it, I've sanitized, and I'm going to pour. So I'll pour the yellow first and then go in with the white, and then the yellow, the white. So that's what I'm gonna keep doing. And I feel like the yellow is really strong, that is covering up the white color, but we'll see how this turns out. Maybe I pour more of the white though. I think that would help. So this is my experiment that I'm doing. I feel like I'm in the science lab. So I have these teeny tiny ones. I'm trying to move my soap without me pouring it. I have this tiny one that I'm going to use as well. So. And the other one too. And I have one more mold so we can finish filling up all our soap. I put my lavender flower. So that's what it looks like after pouring it in the mold. When it's formed, we're going to leave it out for about 30 minutes to 1 hour, and let's see what the time is. It is 1:54. By the time I take it out of the mold, I'll let you know what the time is and how long it takes to form, and we'll take it out of the mold together. See you soon. So it is time to take off our soap. It is 2:31 and the soap looks like it's formed. I'm going to take the teeny tiny ones out first, and look at it just sliding right out. Ooh, love that. So it turned out the way I wanted. I'm so excited. Look at it, guys. That's the first one. And yeah, the lavender flowers are falling off, but that's okay. I only put them there for decoration. So that's the other teeny tiny one, and we're going to move on to the bigger mold. This one first. Look at that one. I think I like the back of the soap, so I'm just gonna turn it that way. Look at it, guys. Mm-hmm. That's my baby. It is beautiful. That's another one. So there we have it, guys. I'm happy. The only thing I have a problem with is the bubbles that formed at the top of the soap, but I think next time I'll just spray with a little bit of rubbing alcohol that should take that out. But other than that, I'm pretty happy, and I love these ones the most, maybe because they have that, you know, on it. So yeah, that's it, guys. You can do this at home. It's easy, it's quick. If not that I'm filming, it shouldn't take more than 10 minutes, and then the wait time for it to form. I'll show you how it works, if it's foaming or how it lathers, and that's it, guys. To see that the soap is working fine and it lathers properly, like, look at that. Turn off the tap. Look at that. Lathering, it looks good. I can't wait to get started on this soap. I hope you make yours. Let me know in the comment section below if you're going to try this sea moss and turmeric soap. Let me know how it turns out, and enjoy if you end up making this soap. Please subscribe to the channel and don't forget to turn on your notification bell. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good one. Bye.